Ghosts are out here possessing everything and anything, from people to dolls and even artwork. Yeah, we can't even buy an original piece of work without worrying about it being cursed and whatnot. Because this has happened a lot. People have bought paintings from thrift stores or wherever, hung them up in their homes, and then they end up getting haunted. So today, let's look at some of these creepy, cursed pieces of art. Hey everyone, what's up and welcome back to Most Amazing Top 10. I'm your host, Lindsay Ivan, and today I'm bringing you the top 10 cursed paintings no one wants to own. Starting off this countdown, we have Miss Bell. For weeks, a man named Alan Smith was haunted by a pale figure of a woman in his mansion. Apparently, this woman would lurk around the hallways and in the bedrooms around 1 o'clock in the morning. She could be seen surrounded by a blue haze and just drifted around the house. Then one day, he found a painting in his house and realized that the woman in the painting was the woman who was haunting him. After doing research, he discovered that the ghost was of a woman named Miss Bell. She used to live in the mansion. But apparently, she went bankrupt and lost all of her possessions. Well, Alan ended up hanging the painting in his home, and ever since then, the haunting stopped. Miss Bell seemed to be at peace. But it's said that no one else can own the painting except the mansion's owner. If the painting ever leaves the premise, Miss Bell will arise again and haunt those until her painting is returned to its proper location. Moving on, number 9, we have the Dead Mother. You may not have heard of this painting by Edvard Munch, but chances are you have seen his famous piece of artwork. Now, this painting is quite dark. It depicts a dead mother laying on her bed while her child stands there covering her ears. This painting is said to represent the devastation that Scandinavia faced due to tuberculosis. Just when you thought the painting couldn't get any worse, it's said that the eyes of the child in the painting will follow you. Others say that they have heard the rustle of the bed sheets from the photo and have heard the mother cough. Others claim that they have seen the mother change positions, or that they've seen the child move, blink, or even disappear from the painting entirely. The painting is for sure cursed. What else can explain this? Coming in at number 8, we have the Rokeby Venus. The Rokeby Venus, otherwise known as Venus at Her Mirror or the Toilet of Venus, is a beautiful painting created in 1658. The painting features a half-naked woman, Venus, staring at herself in a mirror that Cupid is holding. This is actually a lovely painting, but it's said to bring sickness and death to whoever owns it. One woman died mysteriously while the painting was in her family's possession. Other owners were murdered. As a result, no museum or hotel or other place ever wants to own it. Then in 1914, a British female rights activist sliced the painting with a butcher's knife. She did this because she was disgusted by how men were staring at her body all day long. So she took a meat cleaver and sliced it. But rumor has it that the canvas barely got a scratch. Only if you look very close at the painting can you see the slash marks. It's thought that the painting is so strong that not even a physical object can stop it. Moving on to number 7, we have the Witch Girl. Now, I couldn't find much information on this painting. It features a picture of a girl crying, but I don't know who painted it or even the year it was created. All that's said about it is that it's a painting of a witch child, and apparently it's very haunted. So it's said that the painting once belonged to a Spanish man who felt like the girl's eyes in the painting would follow him. He also said that at night a gray silhouette would appear right by the canvas. In fact, many people are convinced that the specter is Madame Delphine LaLaurie herself. LaLaurie was known for torturing her slaves in very, very gruesome ways. But now my question is, why is she haunting this painting? And is it really her? In our 6th spot, we have the Stagecoach painting. So this painting has a very dark and twisted backstory, so no wonder it's cursed. So in 1994, a photographer named James Kidd took a bunch of photos of stagecoaches in Tombstone, Arizona. However, upon developing the photos, he realized that there was a ghost of a headless man standing on a log beside the stagecoach. And then a painter thought it would be a good idea to recreate this photo as an oil painting. And as a result, that ghost attached itself to the painting. Seriously, what did she expect? So when the painting was complete, it was hung out of business. But a couple of days later, the business demanded that she take it back. Apparently, the painting was found crooked every morning, despite them constantly correcting it. They also blamed the painting for paperwork going missing and appointments getting messed up. The painting was just bringing them immense bad luck. Then, when she brought it back home, she started experiencing bad luck herself. Her garage roof started leaking, but roofers couldn't find the source of the leak. And when the painting was moved, the leak stopped. On top of that, things would break on their own and she would hear weird ghostly noises. We're now at our fifth and halfway mark with Bernardo de Galvez. This painting is said to be one of the most haunted paintings in the world. So the painting is a portrait of Bernardo de Galvez, a very powerful Spanish military leader. In the early 1900s, the city of Galveston opened a hotel named after him, and in the hotel they hung this massive portrait of him. But it seems as if Bernardo has attached himself to his portrait. A lot of guests have seen his ghost wandering the halls by his portrait. Others complained about feeling very unsettled while passing by the painting. In fact, a lot of people have reported feeling cold and uneasy when standing close to the portrait. Also, on a number of occasions, if you try to take a photo of the portrait, it will end up coming out blurry or completely dark. So the hotel truly believes that the painting is cursed by Bernardo himself. In our fourth spot, we have Maria Lopukhina. This is a portrait of Maria Lopukhina, a young Russian woman who sadly died of tuberculosis. The painting was made in 1797, a few years before her passing. And now it's said that her restless soul haunts the painting. In fact, it's so cursed that bad luck will fall on whoever looks directly at the painting. It was said that the painting contains some kind of power that can cause healthy young girls to die randomly. In fact, this has happened so often that people are convinced that the portrait actually steals the souls of the girls and traps them inside the painting. In our third spot, we have the suicide girl. Looking at this painting, you wouldn't think there'd be anything to be afraid of. Just wait. So the story goes that a girl committed suicide shortly after creating this image. She drew the picture, scanned it, posted it online, and then she took her own life. Now, legend goes that if you stare into the girl's eyes for too long, then she will get you to take your own life as well. Some that have stared at it for a while have claimed that the portrait turns evil. The girl gets an evil smirk on her face and dark circles appear under her eyes. In our second spot, we have Man Proposes, God Disposes. Painted in 1864 by Edwin Henry Landseer, this painting was inspired by Sir John Franklin's expedition in 1845, when they disappeared without a trace. This painting is how Edwin imagined their fate would be. But little did he know that he created an extremely cursed painting. So this painting is hung up in the exam hall at Royal Holloway University of London. Rumor has it that in the 1970s, a student committed suicide after staring at the painting. All he left behind was a note that read, "The polar bears made me do it." Other students have said that they felt uneasy while sitting next to it. As a result, students purposely go out of their way to avoid this painting, and the university has to cover it up while students are taking tests. And in our number one spot, we have the Anguished Man. This has to be by far the most haunted painting in the world. So story goes that a man named Sean Robinson inherited the painting from his grandmother. The artist of the painting still remains unknown, but it's said that he mixed his own blood with the paint. They ended up killing themselves shortly after finishing the painting. Sean's grandmother was convinced that this painting was haunted. She would hear screaming or crying coming from the painting, and she would often see a shadowy figure by it. As a result, she kept it locked away in her attic. They believed that it was haunted by the ghost of the artist. When Sean inherited the painting, bad things started to happen to him and his family. His son was pushed down the stairs by the ghost, his wife felt someone stroking her hair, and a shadow would lurk through the halls. To this day, Sean keeps the painting locked up in a secure location. It said, "It's far too dangerous for anyone to own." And that's all for today's video. Let's move on to our comment shout-out portion. I'll be shouting out comments from my video, Top 10 Dark Secrets of Disney. Sunny Khan commented, "I always see Lindsay in black. I love it, but she should try some other colors too. She has beautiful complexion that will glow more with colors like peach, blue, etc. Do try it, Lindsay dear." Okay, well, I'm wearing brown, But also, I can do blue, but peach?
No. I'm gonna look naked on camera. It will blend in right with my skin tone. Trust me.
Alyssa Hagood commented, so you're telling me I went on a ride where someone died? Oh my gosh. No. Yeah, kinda, sort of, yes. Sorry about that, but. Your mom commented, please give me a shout out. Oh my God, mom, what are you doing here? Stop it, but here's your shout out. And that's all the comments I'm shouting out for today's video. Make sure to comment something down below for a chance to be featured in my next comment shout out. And as always, don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up and subscribe to Most Amazing Top 10 for more amazing videos. I've been your host, Lindsay Ivan, and I'll see ya when I see ya.